On this episode of the Hockey Card Show, we talk Max Kaminsky, AAA, and Big Bird.
This episode of the Hockey Card Show is brought to you by Ice Hot Hockey. Ice Hot Hockey is 100% hockey cards for the hardcore NHL fan. You can check out all their auctions over on their eBay homepage. Just search for Ice Hot Hockey.
What's up, everybody? Welcome to the Hockey Card Show. I'm Justin Kendrick. You know Darren. We often call him Dinkwood.
Yes, we do.
Or just simply Dink. Mm-hmm. Whichever you prefer.
He's a simple man.
He is a simple man. We are going to sit back and crack some packs of hockey cards, talk about some hockey. It's what we like to do.
Yeah.
Typically, we are drinking beer or rye. We do shots. But we actually have some Dinkwood here brought over some number 99 Wayne Gretzky wine. 07 Cabernet Merlot.
Yeah.
So whatever, we're going to mix it up because
we're styling and profiling.
We're edumacated and
we,
shit.
We sure are.
So yeah, grab a glass. Okay. Yeah. I think we're just going to get right into it, yeah?
Yeah, let's do it. 97. Yeah, I'm wearing the Red Wings jersey, even though it's an 02. Winning jersey because we won in 1997.
I was just down at my buddy's Jeff's house, who's a big Roenick fan. I should have grabbed his ugly Phoenix jersey and wore that.
That would have been cool.
That would have been good.
Mm-hmm. Or if he had a Roenick Flyers jersey.
I think he did.
Not that Roenick was there in 97, but
the number.
We beat them.
That's all we care
in
about.
97.
Oh.
Yeah, that would have been fitting.
Anyway, so I'm going to be doing actually this new stuff, 2010-2011 Donruss from Panini. These are just like their straight up cards, and it's kind of funny, they have an age requirement of 9+ on their cards.
So I don't know if there's something risque in there.
Yeah.
Why 9+? I don't know.
Kind of interesting.
I have the 09-10 Artifacts and Fitting with Zetterberg and Datsyuk on the pack. Since we're talking Red Wings.
Come on, baby. Last few shows I've had issues opening freaking cards.
These are really easy to open. Ooh, I like my last card. I like my last card. But
yeah, I don't really know what to expect with these.
How many you got?
Actually, it looks like a lot. I thought it was only supposed to be 5, but 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
10. You want a few? 5, sure.
4.
No.
That's right, man.
No, that's not gonna work. Here, give me
6.
Here, you have 8. Okay. I'll have 7.
Holy
you
shit.
You go first.
This Wayne shit's good.
Here, I'll give you 8. Does that work?
I'm going first?
Yeah.
Okay, I have Victor Hedman. The, was it number 2 overall?
Yes.
Number 2 overall. Good defenseman. They always, or not always, but they often say he might be kind of like a Lidstrom once he gets into his,
Yeah.
He hasn't really...
His 40s?
Yeah. He doesn't really stick out or stand out that much. And I'm not sure, I don't really know. I don't know why, but...
The team's playing well, though.
And that could be it, maybe, because the whole team's doing so well.
Yeah.
And he's not having to stand out, because this guy Stamkos is pretty good down there.
Yeah. And they just got somebody else, too. They pick up Brewer?
Yes, they did. Yeah. Oh, lots of crazy trades already.
Trades, yeah. Awesome. We were filming on Sunday, Heritage Day. You know, we like to film in advance. So it's just a few days ago that it was trade frenzy.
Trade frenzy.
Okay, I have Mikael Bodker, or Michael Bodker, whatever you want to call him, the Dane. We've had him before. I think I've said before. This is one of your Donruss cards.
Oh, yes.
He played here in town in Kitchener. Don't believe he's on the Coyotes this year or has been the full season. I think he's in the minors, but I could be wrong. Speedy Dane, and he went in the first round as well.
Yeah, we did just have him. Didn't we?
Yeah.
Going back to Hedman, he hit Crosby from behind right there after the Steckel thing. Wasn't it him that
was it him?
Kind of gave him a little oomph, and Crosby was all, oh.
I don't know. Does Sidney do that?
Yeah.
No, he goes, that's terrible. Terrible for the game that he's out.
I got Alex Steen here with St. Louis giving a little wrister on net, probably in warm-ups. Most of you might remember him from Toronto.
Yeah.
Another one of
those
guys.
He's playing all right.
Oh, he just leaves. Everyone leaves. But, hey.
He scored a beauty last night.
Did he?
Yeah. Yeah, like I said, we're filming in advance, so last night the Blues scored 9. I think it's their highest output since 94.
Wow.
They scored 11, but I think they scored 9 last night, so that's bizarro.
Mm-hmm. And his father, Thomas,
yep,
played in the league with Winnipeg and
yes,
some other people, probably, but I know Winnipeg, that's it.
Yes, Thomas Steen. Here we have Thomas Vokoun with the Florida Panthers, formerly of the Nashville Predators. Vokoun's doing okay for Florida this year, considering Florida's not that great. But they'd be even worse without him. I believe
you
said that before. I think he's great. We got his rookie card earlier this season.
Yeah, we did.
With Montreal, remember that? That was cool.
I was saying, Clemenson's down there too, right? I thought,
yes.
I'm not sure if they're sharing time, but I know Clemenson played last night.
Yes.
Again, last night.
Yeah, which is old news now for
right.
The day this comes out.
I have here for Columbus Derek Dorsett or Dorsett.
Yeah, I don't know too much about Derek Dorsett.
Yeah, me neither. The Blue Jackets though recognized his blue collar work ethic and rewarded him by stitching an A on his sweater in the midst of the 09-10 season. But
really? He's got an A and we don't know.
I did not know about him.
No, I like what Keith and Chris call Columbus. The BJs.
The BJs.
All right, I'm into my cards. And the situation hasn't gotten any better. I have Andrew Cogliano.
Cogs,
yeah. Hey. Former world junior player. He won a couple golds, right?
I believe so.
607. He's one of the youngsters. I guess you could call him a youngster in Edmonton.
Yeah. The young core, him and Gagne.
Gagne, yeah. And of course,
they're the same year, right? Came in the same year?
I think so, or he might have been the year before Gagne. I'm not sure.
Because then it was all, I remember, because I'm into the NHL and stuff. In the 1 year, Gagne was rated higher, and they're kind of ribbing him a little bit about it over Cogliano, and then the next year was Cogliano that was higher than Gagne. So
really?
It kind of went back and forth. It's funny.
I think Gagne's probably got some more crafty skills, and Cogliano's got more speed.
Yeah,
that'd be my assessment, but that's just off the top.
I think that little NHL thing came because I'm pretty sure EA took them over to Vancouver, and kind of did a little tour and showed them the game, and that was one of the things they were kind of making fun of them about is the stats, which is fun.
Nice.
It's not about the stats; it's how you control the player.
That's right.
Doesn't matter. I got a rated rookie who, Philip Larson.
Oh, these cards are.
Dallas defenseman. Last year played 2 games, had a point. Highly skilled puck moving defenseman. We all love the puck moving defenseman. But I know dickety all about Philip Larson.
Yeah, where do you play? Is a rookie?
Dallas.
So where did he, does it say where he played? See, it's too bad the cards wouldn't give you more information.
Sometimes.
Sometimes it would be nice to know. I like to know where guys play junior and stuff if I don't already know it. And that's not really helping us out.
No.
I know where this guy played junior.
Hey.
This is Brian Campbell. We've had him many times. We always talk about his big contract. But I always fail to mention that he played junior in Ottawa. And his last year in junior in 99, he lost to Belleville in the second round because Belleville went on. I like to plug Belleville because it's a great place, friendly city. Belleville went on to win the Robertson Trophy. And then Ottawa was the host of the Memorial Cup, so they ran as the host and they won the Memorial Cup. They beat Ottawa. They beat Belleville in the quarters and sevens. So that was kind of crappy. But great junior career. Won the Max Kaminsky Trophy for the best defenseman. And he's had an okay career. Like I said, we always talk about his contract. Because he signed that big one in Chicago, right?
Yes. After going to San Jose from free agency from Buffalo. Or like on the
trade
deadline.
And that trade was Steve Bernier, I think, and a draft pick. And the draft pick Buffalo used to pick Tyler Ennis, who's having a great start to his career.
That's cool.
But yeah, he didn't play very well in San Jose. 20 games, 25 games.
Yeah, I think it was just the end of that season. Just the end
of the season, yeah. Yeah. Anywho.
I have somebody who was recently traded. We were talking about the beginning there. Chris Stewart, who just got traded to St. Louis.
St. Louis.
For Johnson. And whatever, Shattenkirk.
Shattenkirk, yeah. He scored last night, too.
He did. Twice. Nice.
Yeah, that's
too.
What I mean. They scored 9 goals last night. So everybody's scoring. But yeah, he got 2.
I saw that one.
Yeah, he got 2. Steen got 1. I don't know who else.
There you go.
But yeah.
Good young player. I was kind of surprised to see them trade away a forward with Duchesne being hurt. I'm not sure how long he's hurt for.
Well,
kind of. It's like, really?
But I was kind of surprised to see St. Louis trade away a guy that was first overall.
Yeah.
It's one of those trades that you're kind of like, wow, that's weird. But obviously immediately paying dividends for St. Louis, so.
Yeah. No, in Colorado, because they also traded away Anderson. Did a little goalie swap. And
yeah.
And I said on Twitter, it kind of reminded me of the Mueller. Who was the other guy? Last year, Olsen. Traded. Yeah, that is kind of like it's a swap of like fairly equal talent, I thought.
Is that Ryan Miller in the background, or is that Patrick Lee?
No, oh, looks like 30s.
Yeah,
Ryan
so
Miller.
That's Patrick Lee. Good call. Chris Stewart, is that Anthony Stewart's brother?
Don't know.
I believe so.
Tony Stewart, like the NASCAR driver?
Yeah, it's Tony Stewart, yeah, Daytona 500 today. Okay, yeah, I have Ryan Miller, like you just pointed to. I don't know what you want to say about Ryan Miller. We had a bunch of time. Speaking of 30, I've looked at him recently. Stat-wise, he's about 30 wins behind Hasek for the all-time Sabres lead.
Really?
Yeah, career. So that's kind of interesting. I don't know what else you want to say. We've said everything there is to say about
Brother
Ryan Miller.
Brother Drew. Dave Bolin.
Dave Bolin, the missing name from earlier in the season. Remember? I was like, you know that guy.
And now captain of Atlanta?
No, he's still. No, you're thinking of Ladd. But Bolin was another guy that I couldn't remember. He's still in Chicago.
Yeah, sorry.
Yeah, Ladd was the guy we got mixed up at the beginning of the season that was still in Chicago, but he's in Atlanta. Bolin's still there, former London Knight. Pesky little guy. All right. Alright, I just mentioned Steve Bernier, and you have another Bernier coming up. Anyway, okay, my next card is Mark Stahl. We've had Mark Stahl before, have we not? What are these guys?
I think we might have had him
this
year.
We've had some of the Stahls, anyway.
He just got signed to his new contract extension late this year, like September.
Yep.
And I'm pretty sure, besides Redden, I think he's the highest paid defenseman now, because they traded away the other guy. What's his fate? I don't know who it was. The trade some other guy.
One of the Rangers you're talking about?
Yeah. Just earlier. Whatever.
Was that Metric?
Yeah, they just got announced today that they're going to be playing.
Nice. Anywho, Stahl was picked by his brother.
Yeah.
In the draft there at the All-Star game, which was kind of nice. He played with Cogliano, and that's the same 2 gold medal teams, I think.
I think so, sure.
There was a few guys that won 2 of them in a row. Steve Downey was there. Anyway, Stahl also won the same trophy Brian Campbell did for best defenseman in the OHL. Mm. So that's kind of neat. And of course, he has a large family.
I never, like, whatever. You know.
You don't think he's that good?
I don't. He doesn't stand out.
Well, Eric's the best brother.
How about that? Like, when
he's probably third. I think Jordan's awesome, too. Like,
but when I think about, like, top defensemen.
Oh, that way. I thought you meant, like, brother.
I don't know. Or maybe I just forget about him, because it's like, oh, yeah, Mark
Stahl.
Oh, he's
solid, yeah.
But
yeah, you're right. He doesn't really stand out as a...
He's no Jeff Skinner.
Oh.
I don't know where I came from. Not that it has anything to do with anything.
Yeah, not that he's a defenseman or Mark Stahl's a rookie.
I have Jonathan... What? Yeah. I got Jonathan Bernier with L.A., who I believe is seeing a bit more time this year, but Quick's having decent numbers as well.
Well, I think that they projected that Bernier was going to maybe steal Quick's spot this year. So Bernier's getting some time, but not as much time as maybe they thought it was the year Bernier was going to come into his own, and then Quick's...
It seems like every year they talk about...
to where he was last year.
Ooh, here comes
awesome.
Bernier. It's going to be his year.
Don't they say?
Ugh.
Ooh, here comes Bernier.
Here comes Bernier down the right side.
Yeah, but LA's like fighting with those other 17,000 teams that are all within a point of each other. It's ridiculous. I kind of like to see LA get in.
Yeah.
I don't really care. Hey, we didn't update the bet.
No,
I don't even know where it stands. I don't even know where it stands.
I'm sure it's
surely killing Keith.
Probably not good.
You got your last card, I got my last card. Okay, my last card is... it's numbered. Number 741 out of 999 cards. An Artifacts legend. This is Big Bird Larry Robinson. Larry Robinson had a pretty storied career playing and coaching, actually. Playing, he won five or six cups. A few Norrises, Conn Smythe. Was awesome defenseman, awesome. I remember him quite well as a kid in the 80s. And obviously won those cups mostly in the 70s. But I remember those Habs teams when I was really young. He was still dynamite, and then of course went over to LA, and then his coaching career, he coached Jersey.
And LA.
And LA.
I just read it.
Did you?
I was going to say he's way before my time, but I know the name. But it kind of sucks that some of these amazing people are before my time.
That does suck. But think of... Yeah. I was going to say, think of people that are even younger than you.
Yeah.
How they feel. I'm thinking he won at least three coaching. One as an assistant. One... I think he came in 2000 for Robbie Fatorik. Do you remember this? 2000 Jersey, the year that Stevens smoked Lindros.
Yeah.
And went on to win the cup. Jersey fired their coach with 12 games left, and Robinson stepped in, and then they went on to win the cup.
Oh,
so
wow.
He got a nice freebie there. And then he stepped in, I think, when Burns had to leave. I don't know. And then he pulled himself out. I don't know. But I think he's back with the team, so he's had a pretty long storied career with Jersey alone, let alone his years with Montreal. Anyway, ramble enough about Big Bird.
We'll go over to Thomas Vanek. He usually gets injured at least once a year for, 20 games or so. Has some pretty nice dangle. I'd say probably past his time.
I should have wrote that.
Yeah. I'd say maybe 2 years ago, 3 years ago, he was a decent guy you can probably go with on a pool, and I'd stay away from him now.
Yeah, he's a later round guy now, I know, you never know.
Dropped, you never know about
it. He potted 40 though in 1 year, didn't he? Did you just say that?
No, I did not say that. These cards are very uninformative.
I'd say.
Damn you, Donruss, I was so horny.
Yeah, they're nice looking cards, but I personally, at least with these artifacts, they give you the few years, right? Which is always nice. Hey, I just said that. Former Max Kaminsky trophy winner.
Look at you, eh?
He doesn't say that on the back of Brian Campbell's.
I just sat here and said nothing. You're just so smart.
No, that's cool.
I like
when the card says what I said. That's awesome.
I'll give Panini a little credit here. They put ridiculous in on the back of their card. That's pretty good.
Ridiculous?
Yeah, it's usually, I don't think, a word you don't really read.
No.
But that's... Okay, so should Stewart's... What the hell? Okay, I should actually read this. Should Stewart's car ever break down in St. Louis, he shouldn't expect much help from the locals. That's because he was anything but friendly with the Blues and... with the Blues in 09-10, scoring a ridiculous 7 goals and adding 5 assists for 12 points to go along with.
Against the Blues.
Yeah.
And they just traded for him. That's why they wanted him.
That's interesting.
That is interesting.
There you go.
I thought I was going to say something. Don't expect any help because he's a mechanic on the side.
Yeah.
He can fix his own car. But why would they say that if his car ever breaks down?
Yeah. Who writes this shit? We look at these cards every, 88 and 91, and they're horribly written. And these are just hilarious. So great.
Hilarious, right? So if anyone at card manufacturers, if you're looking for people to write for cards,
yeah,
we can write that.
Sure.
Why not?
All right, boys and girls. three star selection time. That's brought to you by Side Hockey. They are 100% hockey cards for the hardcore NHL fan. You can check out all their auctions on their eBay homepage. Just search for them by store name using Ice Hot Hockey. That's all one word. Derek Dorsett. Philip Larson. Oh, I looked up Larson. He's a Dane as well.
Oh, really?
He played over in Europe, so he did not have a junior team. So there you be, boss.
There I be. Because when you put them together, it completes the pole.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah,
Okay, yeah. I'm gonna go first.
Give her.
That's how I go. I'm gonna go, yeah, whatever. I'm gonna go with Victor Hedman as number three. Number two, I'll go with Chris Stewart. And number one, I'm gonna go with Thomas Vanek.
Wow, yeah.
Kind of all over the place. They're all kind of wishy-washy players I got here. So, like, really, they are all wishy-washy
players. Well, I'm going to give third star to Mark Stahl, despite the fact that he doesn't think he's that great. Second star to Ryan Miller, last year's Vezina Trophy winner. And first star to the Big Bird, Larry Robinson.
Hey, Big Bird, why so blue?
Once again, I had, because my mind is always racing, I had something to say when you were talking about Chris Stewart, but I've lost my train of thought.
You're good at that.
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh.
Ooh.
Oh. It's funny how you normally, when I'm talking to someone, when we're not, the camera's on, I'm just kind of like smiling because I probably have something to say. Oh, there it goes. Anyway.
I do the same thing. I just interject.
Yeah, I try to do it too.
So I went out of the market. Market.
Exactly.
Cookies. Hearts. Anyways, guys, thanks for checking out the show. And this is 97. So next is 98. Then we're on to 99.
Yeah, so, we should have drank that on 99. Yeah.
Whatever. We're not that smart.
No.
Thanks for watching. Cheers.